Welcome to my channel. So let us talk about the concept of Java data types. Java data types. See, first of all, what is a data type? What is a data type? So data type means return value. Simply we can say that it is a return value. Return value of what? Return value of variable. Okay, so what is variable? Variable is used to defining a value in a program. Okay, so as per this statement, we can say that data type is used to define variables as well as values, right? So if you take any program, if you take any program in the Java language, that program must contain variables as well as values. So without variable, without value, there is no Java program. So that is the reason we can say that variable is basic building block of program. Okay, so this is the basic introduction about data types. So the simple definition is a data type is used to defining variables and values. And one more point is the return type of variable is called as data type. Let us see in detail. This is the syntax of data type. As we discussed, first of all, we have a return type of variable. So that is nothing but a data type. So data type is used to defining variable. So this variable is nothing but user defined, and this one we can call it as it is a keyword. Okay, and after that we can observe that int is a keyword, a is a variable. Okay, based on first syntax. So these are called syntaxes. Syntax is nothing but grammar of programming language. Okay, so we must follow the statement. So that is nothing but if you define a instruction in a program, we must follow syntax. Okay, this syntax is already defined by the developers. Okay, while you built the programming language. So this data type is keyword. Again, we are using int, variable 1, variable 2, and variable n. Now a, b, c, d. So multiple variables, defining multiple variables, right? So similarly, this is the standard syntax frequently used in the program. Okay, so this data type is nothing but keyword. We are taking integer. We have some more data types we will discuss with the diagram. Okay, so variable means you can define a, x, l, anything you can define. And value, the value is 5. So this 5 value is going to be storing into a. So that is nothing but a value is the 5. So this can be done with the help of data types. Okay, so defining variables and defining values. It is multiple variables and it is a single variable. Okay, so this is the way we have to define data types in Java language.
Like house.
If you take a house, this house contains walls. Okay, so this wall is made up of bricks, cement, water, grills, etc. So from this example, in the similar statement is called, it is one type of instruction. So this instruction contains like bricks, like cement, like sand, like water, like grills. See, this is the kind of example we had to remember to understanding of the concept. So for that reason, we can say that it is a basic building block of program. This house we can consider as a program. Okay, so this is the basic syntax of Java data.
You can use any one of the syntax. Okay, there is no issue, but try to write all the syntaxes in examination, but frequently we are using this.
Java language is classified into two kinds of data types. From that, first one is called as primitive data types and the second one is called as non-primitive data types. So what is the meaning of primitive data types? So primitive and non-primitive. So primitive means it is a fixed. Second one is non-primitive data types. So what is the meaning of non-primitive data types? So non-primitive data types means user-defined data types. So what is the meaning of user-defined data types? So we are going to take a concept. So with the help of this concept, we are using these constants. Okay, so with the help of this, we can develop in the program. So that kind of concept we can call it as non-primitive data types, classes, arrays, interfaces, as well as strings. Okay, so vectors, see, vector is a class, string is a class, all the things are comes under non-primitive data types. So with the help of non-primitive data types, we had to enhance programming in the Java language. Okay, so this is the basic diagram. This is the basic diagram. We can observe the diagram. Basically, it is rich set of data types. Java is rich set of data types. One is called as primitive data types and second one is non-primitive data types. From primitive data types, we had to focus in examination primitive data types, and non-primitive data types we had to discuss in the detail in the chapter wise. Okay, so let us talk about primitive means standard data types in the Java language. So in this primitive side, we have numeric and non-numeric. So in primitive side, we have integer, float, double, long, and from integer side, we have byte, short, followed by int, long. Floating side, we have a float and double. From character side, we had to use char, as well as we can also use string. String is a class as well as data type. From the boolean side, we are using boolean. So these are the standard data types. These are the standard data types of C language, standard data types of Java language. So let us see in detail information about each and every data type. Understand Java data types in detail information. So if you take a data type in Java language, it has four characteristics. The first one is type of the variable. So type of the variables, what kind of type it will be accepted. So like integer, like float value, like long value, like that we have different type of types. Similarly, the second characteristic is comes under size. Okay, size means whatever variable we are taking, that variable how much memory it will be consume, how much memory is taken by the system. So that is the size. And the third characteristic is called it as default value. So every variable has some kind of default value. So the default value based on the programming language as well as based on the data type. And the fourth one is comes under range. So every variable has certain range to define a values. So for example, if you take an integer has some kind of range. Okay, so we can define like 50,000. So this 50,000 will be accepted. But if you define your mobile number, okay, if you define your mobile number, okay, so this is not accepted. Okay, so we should needed some kind of range. So these are the four important points to define a data types. So for more understanding, we can take one example. So the example is like, we can take a car. Okay, so the car is contains fuel type, that means engine type. So the engine type may be petrol, diesel or CNG. Okay, so this is the first characteristic. Second characteristic is size. So the length of the car, like 4 feet or 5 feet, 5 meters, like that, there is a some kind of length we have. Okay, how much space it is occupied in your parking, that is comes in the length. And every car contains some kind of default fuel. Okay, so if you take a latest model's fuel injection system, it contains 5 liters must. Okay, so there is a default value. And range, So the range is, what is the speed range? Okay, so minimum is by default 0, and after that it will be 150 plus, sometimes it may be 180 kilometers per hour, sometimes some cars are contains 120 kilometers the top speed. So there is a range to drive the car. So it has some kind of fixed characteristics. Similarly, if you take a data type, the data type is also contains a fixed kind of characteristics. Okay, I hope you understand what are the characteristics of data type. Let us see in detail. This is the basic diagram of data types. Let us talk about integer data types. So integer data types are classified into 4 data types in the Java: byte, short, int, long. So now we have to talk about byte. Okay, so byte is going to be occupy 1 byte of memory. So 1 byte means, this is 1 byte, you can assume that in the memory location 8 bits 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, so like that it is occupy 8 bits. So here we are going to store the values like zeros and ones in the format, the values will be stored. Okay, so the minimum value is -128, the maximum value is 127, the total range is 256. We can take it as 2 power 7. So the 2 power 7 value is 128, so this is the positive value, and the negative value is 2 power 7 minus 1, so the value is 127. So for easy to understand, you have to define like 2 power 7, so it is occupy 8 bits, we can write like 8 minus 1 7, so that is the 2 power 7 value, right? So this is the byte data type. So how to define byte? Byte A equal to 120 accepted, byte B equal to 130, so it is invalid because out of the range. By default the byte value is 0. Let us take one more value like short. Short is going to be occupied 2 bytes and the width is 16, and this is the range. By default it is going to be take the value like 0, so that is means 16 in the sense what? So this is the memory of short, it is occupies 16 memory blocks like this. Okay, total 16 bits. That means we can take it as 2 power 15 is a maximum value and 2 power 15 minus 1 is minimum value. So you can clearly observe that this is a range. Okay, to define a short value, short A equal to 30,000 accepted, short B equal to 35,000 not accepted, it is acceptable. This is the way we can define the short value. Okay, and after that there is one more value like integer. So frequently we are using integer. Okay, so this integer default value is 0 and it is occupies 4 size of bytes and 32 bits. So 32 bits in the sense we are occupying 32 blocks, 32 in the sense 32, and 32 means 2 power 31 is maximum value and 2 power 31 minus 1 is minimum value. Okay, so you can find out this is the range. So total 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, so the max value 9 digits we can define. Okay, so like int A equal to 7 5 6 7 8 6 5, we can define as an integer. Okay, and the default value is 0. Let us talk about the next long. Take long data type. This long data type is the big data type. It can be occupies up to 8 bytes of memory and it is going to be take the default value either 0 capital L or 0 small l. So that means if you define a long value in, if you define a long value, so the long value must be defined as long A equal to, for example, you want to define a value like 50, it must be associated with the small l, otherwise it is going to be identified as a capital L. So that is nothing but 50 capital L.
So both are acceptable. And if you go for one more value like long C equal to 50, okay, it is a wrong one. Okay, so either small L or capital L must be identified. 64, that means if you take a memory total, it occupies 64 blocks here, and 2 power 63 is the maximum value. 2 power 63 minus 1 is a minimum value. So this is the way we have to define integers. Okay, so this is called integer data type. And you can also observe one point. Okay, so Java does not support like unsigned integers as well as signed integers. Not required to define unsigned and unsigned integers. And that is nothing but unsigned means values from 0 to positive. Signed means values from 0 to negative from C and C++. Okay, so unsigned integers, basically we are using unsigned means positive side from 0 onwards. And one more point we had to talk, that is nothing but no format specifiers. No format specifiers. In C language we are using percentile D for the integer, percentile F is for the float. So like that we are using number of format specifier, but here not required. Okay, directly we can use. Let us see in the program in detail. Let us talk about the next data type, that is comes under floating data type. So what is floating data type? So floating data type means we can give the pointed values. Pointing values. Okay, so pointing values in the sense after number we are going to define decimals. Okay, so these decimals we can define by using float. Java language to define real values. Okay, so real values in the sense pointed values. Okay, so pointed value means, so we are going to define a number, after the number we had to define some kind of precision value. So some kind of precision value. Okay, so here we are going to define like 0 0 0 0 0, like this we have to define. So to define such kind of number in the Java language, we have two data types. The first one we can call it as float, and the second one we can call it as double. Okay, so basically in a programming side, to define a price or currency value, we have to define like 99.275, like that. And similarly we can define measurements. So to measure some length of the wall or some kind of area, we should use this kind of real numbers. Similarly, sometimes we have to define time also. So to define times in the form of seconds, okay, like milliseconds. So like so and so hours, so and so minutes, so and so seconds, we must use this kind of real notation. See, let us take a float. So float side. So float is a common real data type to define floating point values. So here the float is going to be defined value, which is decimal format, and after decimal format the value must be associated with small f, or the value is associated with capital F. Capital F. So this is the way we have to define floating value. For example, there is a data type like float is a data type, and I have to define like length equal to 7.01. It is invalid. But the same thing we have to define like this: float L equal to 7.01 F. It is valid. Otherwise, float L equal to 7.01 capital F. So this one is valid as well as this one is valid as well as this one is valid. So that means a value must be associated with the either small f or capital F. And one more point, by default decimal value is double. Okay, default decimal value is the double. And in this area the precision means this side, seven the floating of values. Okay, 7 digits of values. And for double it is accepting 16 digits. Okay, so basically it is IEEE 748 standard. Okay, and every value is associated with the E. basically we have to define e notation. So this e notation we can call it as scientific notation. So assume that there is a float value and the length equal to, I'm defining like 3.41E7. okay, so this is the wrong one and we should defining either small f or capital F. So what is the meaning of this? That means the e means, this e means 3.41 into, that means star 10 power 7. So this is the meaning of this. Let us take one more example for more clarity. We can define float width equal to some 7.12E19F. You can use small f or capital F. What is the exact meaning of this? That means 7.12 star 10 power 19. So this is the meaning of E. Basically in general notation, E value is like 2.78818. Okay, but here we are using like this. Generally E value in the scientific notation 2.7828, but we are not using this. So in place of that, star 10 power remains value, remaining decimal value. Okay, so this is the way we have to define the floating value. But by default double is the decimal value, but to save the memory we should use the float, and the float is going to be associated with either small f or capital F. This is the way we have to define float and double. So here wrong printing value. Double is occupying 8 bytes and it is occupying 4 bytes. Okay, so let us understand with the information. So floating value is basically defining the real numbers and it occupy the 4 bytes. 4 bytes means 32 bits. Okay, and we can use unlimited memory. So basically unlimited memory locations, and this location is in the standard of IEEE 748 standard. Okay, similarly we can define double also. So double is associated with the 64, but sometimes double value is 0.0, D is accepted, 0.0, both will be accepted. So this is the range of float value and this is the range of double value. Okay, so by default float value 0.0F or 0.0 capital F, for double value 0.0 or 0.0D. So these are the default values of floating. Talk about the character data type. So the character data type is associated with char. Okay, so char is a data type, and in the char we have to define value in single quotations. So the single quotation value is either number or either alphabet or number or any kind of special symbol, all will be accepted, but only one character. The default value is backslash u 0000. So this is the default value. So this is the default value of Unicode system. So let us discuss later what is Unicode system. Java supports Unicode system. It is a combination of different type of character set. It supports 65,537. So later we will talk about what is Unicode system and all. Okay, so this is the lowest value. And coming to the highest value, backslash u followed by FFFF. So this is the highest value of Unicode and this is the lowest value. Okay, so this is the way we have to define character. For example, I'm going to define 3 examples here. So like char ch1 equal to in single quotations A. Similarly char ch2 equal to single quotations 5. Char ch3 in single quotations @. So this is the way we have to define character in Java language. Only one character is allowed. next data type is comes under string data type. So string is nothing but group of values which is associated with the double quotations. That means in double quotations 1, 2, 3, 4 accepted, A, B, C, D accepted, $@, underline it will be accepted, otherwise combination will be accepted. So what I'm saying to you, in Java language S must be capital and remaining we have to write like this. This string we can use as class, as well as string we can use as data type. Okay, so string can be used as two things. One is class. So class we'll talk later stages. Now we have to focusing on data type. For example, I'm going to write string s1 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 accepted, string s2 equal to abcd accepted. So this is the way we have to defining the strings in Java language. No limit to defining data, and it is a default data type of Java language. In C language the default data type is the integer, whereas Java language the default data type is string, is a default data type. Okay, so each and everything is in the form of strings, right? See, the last data type from primitive side, boolean. So boolean is one type of keyword, as well as it is a special data type from Java language, and it accepts only two values, and the first value we can call it as true, and the second value we can call it as false. Okay, so that means if you want to define a value as a true or false, we should use boolean. So boolean a equal to true, otherwise boolean b equal to false. So this is the way we have to define boolean. C language supports zeros and ones. Okay, that is true and false, but here we have to define true or false. Okay, non-primitive data types. See, by using particular concept that may be array, class, that may be interface. So with the help of these concepts we are going to write large programs. So here we can use primitive data types. With the help of primitive data types we are going to develop non-primitive data type programs. So this is the real-time programs in the Java. So what I'm saying to you, if you define any program, data type must be, if you define any program in Java language, data type is must. That is the reason we can call it as data types are basic building blocks of Java language. I hope you understand this video. Like and share. Thank you for watching. Bye.